we've reached the stage where video collaboration is becoming one of the more important and more team-centric ways of people working. Let's now think out the next 1, 3, 5 sort of years. It's hard to go past that, but what are some of the trends that you're seeing and some of the directions that, you know, Logitech is thinking and technologies that you're looking at to help us go to the next level for collaboration?
So it's a bunch of things. I would say in the near term, because we've gotten to this point now where the technology has hit the mainstream, I think there's just a lot of room to be able to change the culture and get video in every room. So today, in fact, the usage is relatively low around the world. Even though we've made a lot of success, it's still only about 2.5% of all rooms around the world have video. So a lot of rooms will have a screen, they'll have a speakerphone, but they don't have video yet. So part of our ambition and part of what we see is companies are moving from putting video in a select number of boardrooms to just putting it in every room. Think about the idea that if you walked into a conference room, you would never ever hear someone say, well, there's room for 8, but we only bought 6 chairs because the ROI just didn't cut it. You'll see the same thing with video, where people are just going to put video in every room because it's just the way people work. So I would say that's one thing. I would say the second thing is we're going to be moving from the resolution wars where people go from 720 to 1080 to 4K. I'd say we're almost kind of done there. You really don't need a lot better than 1080p or 4K systems. And then we'll see more around ease of use and making systems smarter. So part of how you'll do that is add things like computer vision and AI so that you can basically address some of the things that are hard today. Like, for example, I've got a remote control in front of me, but I bet our listeners don't really aspire to use a remote control. So you'll have cameras get smarter, so they'll be able to do things like auto crop. So you walk into a meeting, and it'll automatically see how many humans in the room and just automatically change that. And then once you can see, there are a bunch of other things that you'll be able to do, from counting people into a room to looking around the room and a bunch of other exciting things that I think will make it easier to use. So it's not just about adding features, it's about making them smarter so the end user has to do less.
Well, I think that last topic where you're discussing sort of bringing intelligence to the cameras, it's very hard to go anywhere in the tech world these days without discussing artificial intelligence and machine learning. For end users, they don't have to know those terminologies. They don't have to understand the technology that's behind it. They're just getting better experiences out of this. And it's interesting, as we evolve with the meeting experiences, like you and I were having a great conversation the other day around how, you know, if we can make meetings even better in these online and virtual environments than they are face-to-face. It's not just about catching up. It's about using this intelligence to do things that you may not even be able to do if you are physically present in a meeting. Is that correct?
No, you're absolutely right. So I think we have two models that we're aspiring to. So one is when we think about what we want to do in video, we actually think less about the model of Silicon Valley and more about Hollywood. Because if you think about Hollywood, they've spent 100 years perfecting the art of knowing how to move a camera around that pleases human beings. And we just want to apply that to meetings. So if you think about it, if you're in a meeting, most of us are smart enough to look around and know where the action is. Sometimes you look at the active speaker. Sometimes you look at two people who are talking. And in some cases, you're looking at someone who's just listening because you want to know maybe the decision maker is kind of taking it all in. And human beings are good at that. Cameras right now are relatively dumb. So our vision is we want to make the effect of Steven Spielberg in every meeting room. If Steven Spielberg was in here, he'd know exactly where to put the camera, where the action's at. We just want to do that in AI and software. So that's part of our vision.
I can't tell you how much I love that phrase and that concept about making work more like Hollywood and less like Silicon Valley.